Representative Dennis Kucinich, who joins us live from Capitol Hill. He's a five-term congressman from Ohio's 10th District, a former mayor of Cleveland, and a two-time Democratic presidential candidate. Earlier this month, Congressman Kucinich introduced 35 articles of impeachment against President Bush on the floor of the House of Representatives. The House responded by a vote of 251 to 166 to refer the articles to a committee, which many observers conclude is simply a way of burying it, since it will never see light of day there. Of the 35 articles, about a half deal with Iraq, five deal with civil liberties, four deal with abuses of executive power, and the rest with a range of issues, ranging going from Katrina to global warming. At the end of each of the articles, this is what Congressman Kucinich concludes. At the end of each article, this is the words that are used. Let me put them up on the screen so we can read them. In all of these actions and decisions, President George W. Bush has acted in a manner contrary to his trust as president and commander-in-chief and subversive of the constitutional government, to the prejudice of the cause of law and justice, and to the manifest injury of the people of the United States. Wherefore, President George W. Bush, by such conduct, is guilty of an impeachable offense warranting removal from office. Congressman, thanks for joining us.
Thank you, Jim Zogby. It's a pleasure and an honor to be with you on your show, Viewpoint.
Those are tough words. How did the Congress greet them?
Well, they were referred to committee, and I actually made the motion to refer it to committee because when you have 35 articles, it makes sense that you would want members to take the time to read them. I think the principal and gravest offense is misleading Congress, lying to Congress to lead us into a war. Mm-hmm. And there are many specifications to that charge. And we are now in a war that has cost the life of over 4,000 of our brave young men and women, the lives of over 1 million innocent Iraqis, the destruction of our domestic agenda. We really need to insist on the rule of law, on truth, in order to save our democracy. So that's why I introduced those articles.
Now, sending them to committee, from what we're hearing, they won't come out of committee. What do you think the likelihood is that any action will be taken? And if not, what will you do about it?
Well, it's already been made clear to me that the leadership of Congress has said that they have no interest in pursuing impeachment. I think this is a strategic and a dangerous mistake which upsets the balance of power in Washington, that it helps defeat an imperial presidency. It demolishes checks and balances and Congress's position of co-equality. What I've said I will do is, if there is no hearing in the Judiciary Committee on any of the articles, then I will proceed to reintroduce articles when Congress returns in the first week of July or the second week of July.
Thanks, Dan. I have a couple of phones holding, a couple of people holding on the phones. Yeah, time for a few calls?
Let's do it.
Let's go to Texas for our first call. Caller?
Congressman Kucinich, I applaud your efforts to indict these criminals, and I want you to know that I have financially contributed to your campaign as well as Ron Paul's campaign. And I want to say that these guys, the reason they want impeach is because these other Democrats want to preserve these same powers for their presidents. And I would also like to get your viewpoints on what are the contributions of AIPAC and Israel to these unnecessary wars that we're involved.
Let me stop you right there, because I want Congressman to have one question to answer. Thanks. Well, thank you. Thanks for the call.
Yeah, let me say that I have spoken to people who are Israeli citizens who reject what the Bush administration is doing in the Middle East, who believe that by not taking an even-handed approach, the Bush administration has contributed to making peace much more difficult, that we have people in the American Jewish community, in organizations such as Peace Now and Brit Tzedek, who are very adamant about taking a new direction so you respect the rights of the Palestinians. And so we have to realize that there's no monolith out there. What's important is for people of goodwill and people who are like-minded in pursuit of peace and justice come together so that we can help mm-hmm. our Israeli and our Palestinian brothers and sisters reconcile their differences, but to do it in the context of protecting the basic human rights of the Palestinians, and you can also assure security for the Israelis. This shouldn't be hard to do. It's just made hard to do because there's one group of people who has enormous influence, and they're using that influence to keep us from coming together.
And the site again is Kucinich.us. Right. That's where the articles are. Take a look and see.
And if people want to sign up, they can do that there.
Okay, thank you so much, Congressman.
Thank you.
When we come back, a discussion on oil prices with international economist George Abed and more of your calls. Stay tuned.